So how can we think of this QR algorithm? Well, one way to think about it is that we do a QR factorization of A, and what we notice is that this matrix right here is really equal to this matrix right here. Now, what did we learn about doing a unitary similarity transformation, which is what this computation here represents? This is a term that we discussed in week 9. A similarity transformation like that really says, let's take our matrix A and let's look at it in a different basis. Okay. So what's happening on this side here is we compute the QR factorization and then we say, let's adjust the basis in which we view our matrix A. And then let's continue our subspace iteration, but now by resetting the matrix V, the matrix that we multiply A by to be the identity, and then do another step of our subspace iteration. So the idea is start with the identity, do one step of subspace iteration, adjust the basis in which you view it, do another step of subspace iteration, except that in this new basis, our vector that we would have multiplied by A now becomes the identity matrix again in that basis. Then you do another step of subspace iteration and you keep doing that. And what you notice then is that this matrix A eventually becomes the diagonal matrix. And if you accumulate all of these transformations of the bases that you encountered along the way, what you end up with is a matrix where the columns of that matrix equal the eigenvectors associated with the eigenvalues that appear on the diagonal of matrix A. And that's how the two are related to each other. But this is surprisingly simple. Compute the QR factorization of A, multiply Q by R. Now, this is far from a practical algorithm. Why? Well, we know that the power method can converge very slowly. Okay? Also, we know that performing a QR factorization requires order n cubed computation, and then multiplying r times q requires another order m cubed computation. And then accumulating all of these requires yet another order m cubed computation. Now, experience tells us, and your experience isn't there quite yet, that we actually have to do order m iterations in order to find all of the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, even after we tweak this algorithm to become quite a bit more practical. So that means that overall this algorithm is an order m to the fourth algorithm. And in our field, in numerical linear algebra, an algorithm that requires order n to the fourth is unacceptably expensive. So this algorithm is not practical yet, but we're one step towards having a practical algorithm.